RAMs wake up your PC with a performance upgrade that gives you faster startups, increased responsiveness, and quicker application load times. This is JC, how are you doing today? And this is your Corsair Vengeance. The Corsair Vengeance is a RAM I've been looking at for a while, and I decided I'm going to give it a try, and I can't wait to put it to the test inside my PC. And what I like the package it comes with. It comes in a beautiful black and yellow box. Almost looking like the Pittsburgh Steeler color. You can see it's a DDR4 with two 16 GBs, total up to 32 GBs of RAM, with a speed up to 3200, and it's backwards compatible to like 2966 or 2666. So this is good for older PCs. It's backwards compatible. And also, I like some features it got. For example, it got better protection for the chips. Unlike the Kingston, my favorite right here, the Kingston Fury Impact, you only got one sticker to protect the chips at the front, but at the back, it doesn't have a sticker to protect the chips at the back. The Corsair Vengeance now comes with two stickers, one at the front and one at the back. So you're going to get optimal protection for your chips, because you know when you're playing a lot of games, you're watching your YouTube videos, or you're watching Netflix, or you got multiple websites open up on your laptop, you know it generates a lot of heat. And these stickers right here will give you extra protection, give the chips extra protection alongside with the heat shield that you got for it. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this bad boy inside my PC and do a series of tests with it, all right? Let's get into it. As you can see, the Corsair Vengeance is a single rank RAM, and you can see right here these are the timings of the RAM, and I think this timing is very, very impressive. As you can see, in slot one got the 16, in slot two, so we got another 16, the same thing, XMP 2.0, and these are the parts number, but it doesn't put a serial number right here. This is some impressive times. I'm very, very impressed. This is my favorite part, the stress test. What I usually do with my RAMs, I open up a bunch of websites and a bunch of applications, and I do that to see how well the RAM can sustain all of these things running without closing any app or any web page, and it still maintains the same performance. All right, so I got several websites up and running right now. The first one is Walmart, as you can see. Let me scroll up and down. You can see there's no lag, perfectly fine. Let's go with Samsung. Same thing with Samsung. Let me close this right here. Close all this extra stuff. I don't know what this extra stuff at. And see, everything's scrolling just fine. I need to get my mouse. I'm using something else, but still, I got it perfectly fine. You see that? No issue at all. Let's go to Apple. See? No issue at all. It's still doing a great job. I need to get my wireless mouse, man. Still doing a great job under pressure. See, I got four websites up and running. One of my favorite places, Best Buy. Still doing this thing. So let's even click an item on the websites. Boom. No issue. That's Best Buy. Let's click Apple. Let's go to boom. See, no issue. Still doing a fantastic job. Or Samsung. Let's click another one for Samsung displays. Still no issue at all. The reason why I choose these websites, because they're big, they got so much data, so much things going on, and this will really push the RAMs hard. So go back to Wally World. Still no issue at all. So let's go to YouTube. my favorite YouTuber. This is who I respect and idolize, Mr. Flossy Carter. Let me just click one of his videos and see what pop up.
Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Floss. Back again with another
That's
video.
Pretty impressive.
Today we're gonna take a look at
That's this. Pretty impressive. Very impressive. And remember, I got 4 web pages up and running, plus YouTube. Not only that, I got 3 powerful games in the background as well. I got 3 powerful games. I got God of War, I got Forza, I got Netflix going on at the same time. So let's click God of War. Let me start it up real quick. Got to turn my controller on. Hope my battery don't. Oh, my battery's not dead. Okay. Let's crack in. So far, so good. And the thing with God of War, look at the FPS. It's saying that 41 FPS. The reason why it's saying so low, in order for me to get it like this, I'd have to put it in windowed. So let me get out of here. And let me change something real quick. I'm gonna take it out of windowed. And let me put it to the fullest. Let me go back to borderless. So I could get the full thing. Okay, now I'm back. And FPS under all that stress, still pretty impressive. And I got so many things going on at the same time. So just imagine if everything was closed and this game was running by itself. See, no, just standing around and getting easily 50 something. And remember, I got several things running on the background as well. Let's go to Forza. Forza, you can see right there, Forza is running with no lag at all. And look at that, I'm getting easy 60 to 70 FPS's, and the gameplay is running smooth with no issue at all. And remember, I got several things running, so this RAM is doing a fantastic job. Now I'm going to Netflix.
And I hope man is helpful.
Please, all of that's good. So, what I can say about the Corsair Vengeance, It's a bad RAM. It does multitasking well. It does everything as well. So for my next video, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do nothing but gaming. I'm gonna do the benchmarks, and so you can see for yourself how well this RAM is under some extreme pressure from games. All right, this is JC. Thanks you guys for tuning in. I hope to see you in the next video. All right, peace out.